This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. See Text Diversity 85,000 Recognized Living Species Cornu aspersum, formerly Helix aspersa, a common land snail. The mollusks, or mollusks, MLSCs, compose the large phylum of invertebrate animals known as the mollusca. Around 85,000 extant species of mollusks are recognized. Mollusks are the largest marine phylum, comprising about 23% of all the named marine organisms. Numerous mollusks also live in freshwater and terrestrial habitats. They are highly diverse, not just in size and in anatomical structure, but also in behavior and in habitat. The phylum is typically divided into 9 or 10 taxonomic classes, of which 2 are entirely extinct. Cephalopod mollusks, such as squid, cuttlefish and octopus, are among the most neurologically advanced of all invertebrates, and either the giant squid or the colossal squid is the largest known invertebrate species. The gastropods, snails and slugs are by far the most numerous mollusks in terms of classified species, and account for 80% of the total. The scientific study of mollusks is called malacology. The three most universal features defining modern mollusks are a mantle with a significant cavity used for breathing and excretion, the presence of a radula except for bivalves, and the structure of the nervous system. Other than these things, mollusks express great morphological diversity. So many textbooks base their descriptions on a hypothetical ancestral mollusk. See image below. This has a single, limpet-like shell on top, which is made of proteins and chitin reinforced with calcium carbonate, and is secreted by a mantle covering the whole upper surface. The underside of the animal consists of a single muscular foot. Although mollusks are chelomates, the coelom tends to be small. The main body cavity is a hemiseal through which blood circulates. Their circulatory systems are mainly open. The generalized mollusk's feeding system consists of a rasping tongue, the radula, and a complex digestive system in which exuded mucus and microscopic, muscle-powered hairs called cilia play various important roles. The generalized mollusk has 2 paired nerve cords, or 3 in bivalves. The brain, in species that have 1, encircles the esophagus. Most mollusks have eyes, and all have sensors to detect chemicals, vibrations, and touch. The simplest type of molluscan reproductive system relies on external fertilization, but more complex variations occur. All produce eggs, from which may emerge trochophore larvae, more complex veliger larvae, or miniature adults. Good evidence exists for the appearance of gastropods, cephalopods and bivalves in the Cambrian period 541. But with a risk of food poisoning from toxins that accumulate in mollusks under certain conditions, and many countries have regulations to reduce this risk. Mollusks have, for centuries, also been the source of important luxury goods, notably pearls, mother of pearl, Tyrian purple dye, and sea silk. Their shells have also been used as money in some pre-industrial societies. Mollusk species can also represent hazards or pests for human activities. The bite of the blue-ringed octopus is often fatal, and that of Octopus apollyon causes inflammation that can last for over a month. Stings from a few species of large tropical cone shells can also kill, but their sophisticated, though easily produced, venoms have become important tools in neurological research. Schistosomiasis, also known as bilharzia, bilharziosis or snail fever, is transmitted to humans via water snail hosts, and affects about 242 shell, 43 foot, 44 circulatory system, 45 respiration, 46 eating, digestion, and excretion, 47 nervous system, 48 reproduction, 5 ecology, 51 feeding, 6 classification, 7 evolution, 71 fossil record, 72 phylogeny, 8 human interaction, 81 uses by humans, 811 bioindicators, 812 stings and bites, 813 parasites, 814 pests, 9 footnotes, 10 references, 11 bibliography, 12 external links. Etymology: the words mollusk and mollusk are both derived from the French mollusque, which originated from the Latin molluscus, from mollus, soft. Molluscus was itself an adaptation of Aristotle's ta malaka, ta malaka, the soft things, which he applied to cuttlefish. The name molluscoida was formerly used to denote a division of the animal kingdom containing the brachiopods, bryozoans, and tunicates, the members of the three groups having been supposed to somewhat resemble the mollusks. As it is now known, these groups have no relation to mollusks, and very little to one another. The name molluscoida has been abandoned. Definition: the most universal features of the body structure of mollusks are a mantle with a significant cavity used for breathing and excretion, and the organization of the nervous system. The most abundant metallic element in mollusks is calcium. Mollusks have developed such a varied range of body structures, it is difficult to find synapomorphies defining characteristics to apply to all modern groups. The most general characteristic of mollusks is they are unsegmented and bilaterally symmetrical. The following are present in all modern mollusks. The dorsal part of the body wall is a mantle or pallium which secretes calcareous spicules, plates or shells. It overlaps the body with enough spare room to form a mantle cavity. The anus and genitals open into the mantle cavity. There are two pairs of main nerve cords. Other characteristics that commonly appear in textbooks have significant exceptions. Scaphopoda radula, a rasping tongue with chitinous teeth absent in 20% of neomeniomorpha. Yes, no internal, cannot extend beyond body broad, muscular foot reduced or absent. Yes, modified into arms. Yes, small, only at front and dorsal concentration of internal organs visceral mass. Not obvious. Yes, large digestive CECA. No CECA in some aplicophora. Yes, no large complex metanephridia kidneys. None. Yes, small, simple diversity. About 80% of all known mollusk species are gastropods, snails and slugs, including this cowrie. A sea snail. Estimates of accepted described living species of mollusks vary from 50,000 to a maximum of 120,000. Preserved, must be many times greater than the number alive today. Mollusks have more varied forms than any other animal phylum. They include snails, slugs and other gastropods, clams and other bivalves, squids and other cephalopods, and other lesser known but similarly distinctive subgroups. The majority of species still live in the oceans, from the seashores to the abyssal zone, but some form a significant part of the freshwater fauna and the terrestrial ecosystems. Mollusks are extremely diverse in tropical and temperate regions, but can be found at all latitudes. About 80% of all known mollusk species are gastropods. Cephalopoda such as squid, cuttlefish, and octopuses are among the neurologically most advanced of all invertebrates. The giant squid, which until recently had not been observed alive in its adult form, is one of the largest invertebrates, but a recently caught specimen of the colossal squid, 10. Extinctions since the year 1500 are of mollusks, consisting almost entirely of nonmarine species. A generalized mollusk. Further information: mollusk shell anatomical diagram of a hypothetical ancestral mollusk. Because of the great range of anatomical diversity among mollusks, many textbooks start the subject of molluscan anatomy by describing what is called an archy mollusk, hypothetical generalized mollusk, or hypothetical ancestral mollusk. Ham to illustrate the most common features found within the phylum. These species reproduce through binary fission, much like a sea star. The depiction is rather similar to modern monoplacophorans, and some suggest it may resemble very early mollusks. The generalized mollusk is bilaterally symmetrical and has a single, limpet-like shell on top. The shell is secreted by a mantle covering the upper surface. The underside consists of a single muscular foot. The visceral mass, or visceropallium, is the soft, nonmuscular metabolic region of the mollusk. It contains the body organs mantle and mantle cavity. The mantle cavity, a fold in the mantle, encloses a significant amount of space. It is lined with epidermis, and is exposed, according to habitat, to sea, fresh water or air. The cavity was at the rear in the earliest mollusks, but its position now varies from group to group. The anus, a pair of osphradia chemical sensors in the incoming lane, the hindmost pair of gills and the exit openings of the nephridia kidneys and gonads. Reproductive organs are in the mantle cavity. The whole soft body of bivalves lies within an enlarged mantle cavity. Shell. Main article: mollusk shell. The mantle edge secretes a shell secondarily absent in a number of taxonomic groups, such as the nudibranchs, that consists of mainly chitin and conchiolin, a protein hardened with calcium carbonate, except the outermost layer in almost all cases is all conchiolin. C. Periostracum. Mollusks never use phosphate to construct their hard parts, with the questionable exception of Cobcrephora. While most mollusk shells are composed mainly of aragonite, those gastropods that lay eggs with a hard shell use calcite, sometimes with traces of aragonite, to construct the eggshells. The shell consists of three layers: the outer layer, the periostracum, made of organic matter, a middle layer made of columnar calcite, and an inner layer consisting of laminated calcite, often nacreous foot play media. A 50-second video of snails, most likely Natica chemnitzi and Cerithium stercusmuscarum, feeding on the sea floor in the Gulf of California, Puerto Peñasco, Mexico. The underside consists of a muscular foot, which has adapted to different purposes in different classes. For the foot carries a pair of statocysts, which act as balance sensors in gastropods. It secretes mucus as a lubricant to aid movement in forms having only a top shell, such as limpets. The foot acts as a sucker attaching the animal to a hard surface, and the vertical vertical muscles clamp the shell down over it. In other mollusks, the vertical muscles pull the foot and other exposed soft parts into the shell in bivalves. The foot is adapted for burrowing into the sediment. For in cephalopods it is used for jet propulsion. For in the tentacles and arms are derived from the foot circulatory system. Mollusks' circulatory systems are mainly open, although mollusks are chelomates. Their coeloms are reduced to fairly small spaces enclosing the heart and gonads. The main body cavity is a hemiseal through which blood and chelomic fluid circulate and which encloses most of the other internal organs. These hemicelic spaces act as an efficient hydrostatic skeleton. The blood contains the respiratory pigment hemocyanin as an oxygen carrier. The heart consists of one or more pairs of atria auricles, which receive oxygenated blood from the gills and pump it to the ventricle, which pumps it into the aorta main artery, which is fairly short and opens into the hemiseal. The atria of the heart also function as part of the excretory system by filtering waste products out of the blood and dumping it into the coelom as urine. A pair of nephridia, little kidneys, to the rear of and connected to the coelom extracts any reusable materials from the urine and dumps additional waste products into it, and then ejects it via tubes that discharge into the mantle cavity. Respiration. Most mollusks have only one pair of gills, or even only one gill generally. The gills are rather like feathers in shape, although some species have gills with filaments on only one side. They divide the mantle cavity so water enters near the bottom and exits near the top. Their filaments have three kinds of cilia, one of which drives the water current through the mantle cavity, while the other two help to keep the gills clean. If the osphradia detect noxious chemicals or possibly sediment entering the mantle cavity, the gill's cilia may stop beating until the unwelcome intrusions have ceased. Each gill has an incoming blood vessel connected to the hemiseal and an outgoing one to the heart. Eating, digestion, and excretion. Snail medulla at work. Process is by no means perfect. Periodically, circular muscles at the hindgut's entrance pinch off and excrete a piece of the prostyle, preventing the prostyle from growing too large. The anus, in the part of the mantle cavity, is swept by the outgoing lane of the current created by the gills. Carnivorous mollusks usually have simpler digestive systems as the head has largely disappeared in bivalves. The mouth has been equipped with labial palps, two on each side of the mouth, to collect the detritus from its mucous nervous system. Simplified diagram of the mollusk nervous system. The cephalic mollusks have two pairs of main nerve cords organized around a number of paired ganglia, the visceral cords serving the internal organs and the pedal ones serving the foot. Most pairs of corresponding ganglia on both sides of the body are linked by commissures, relatively large bundles of nerves. The ganglia above the gut are the cerebral, the pleural, and the visceral, which are located above the esophagus gullet. The pedal ganglia, which control the foot, are below the esophagus, and their commissure and connectives to the cerebral and pleural ganglia surround the esophagus in a circumesophageal nerve ring or nerve collar. The acephalic mollusks' bivalves also have this ring, but it is less obvious and less important. The bivalves have only three pairs of ganglia: cerebral, pedal, and visceral, with the visceral as the largest and most important of the three, functioning as the principal center of thinking. Some, such as the scallops, have eyes around the edges of their shells which connect to a pair of looped nerves and which provide the ability to distinguish between light and shadow. Reproduction. See also, reproductive system of gastropods. Apical tuft. Cilia. Prototrach. Cilia. Stomach. Mouth. Metatrach. Cilia. Mesoderm. Anus. Equals cilia. Trochophore. Larva. The simplest molluscan reproductive system relies on external fertilization, but with more complex variations all produce eggs, from which may emerge trochophore larvae, more complex veliger larvae, or miniature adults. Two gonads sit next to the coelom, a small cavity that surrounds the heart, into which they shed ova or sperm. The nephridia extract the gametes from the coelom and emit them into the mantle cavity. Mollusks that use such a system remain of one sex all their lives and rely on external fertilization. Some mollusks use internal fertilization and/or are hermaphrodites, functioning as both sexes. Both of these methods require more complex reproductive systems. The most basic molluscan larva is a trochophore, which is planktonic and feeds on floating food particles by using the two bands of cilia around its equator to sweep food into the mouth, which uses more cilia to drive them into the stomach, which uses further cilia to expel undigested remains through the anus. New tissue grows in the bands of mesoderm in the interior, so the apical tuft and anus are pushed further apart as the animal grows. The trochophore stage is often succeeded by a veliger stage in which the prototrach, the equatorial band of cilia nearest the apical tuft, develops into the velum veil, a pair of cilia bearing lobes with which the larva swims. Eventually, the larva sinks to the sea floor and metamorphoses into the adult form, while metamorphosis is the usual state in mollusks. The cephalopods differ in exhibiting direct development. The hatchling is a miniaturized form of the adult ecology. Feeding most mollusks are herbivorous, grazing on algae or filter feeders for those grazing, too. Feeding strategies are predominant. Some feed on microscopic, filamentous algae, often using their radula as a rake to comb up filaments from the sea floor. Others feed on macroscopic plants such as kelp, rasping the plant surface with its radula. To employ this strategy, the plant has to be large enough for the mollusk to sit on, so smaller macroscopic plants are not as often eaten as their larger counterparts. Filter feeders are mollusks that feed by straining suspended matter and food particle from water, typically by passing the water over their gills. Most bivalves are filter feeders. Cephalopods are primarily predatory, and the radula takes a secondary role to the jaws and tentacles in food acquisition. The Monoplacophora neopelina uses its radula in the usual fashion, but its diet includes protists such as the Xenophyophore stanophyllum sacoglossan. Sea slugs suck the sap from algae, using their one-row radula to pierce the cell walls, whereas dorid nudibranchs and some Vetigastropoda feed on sponges and others feed on hydroids. An extensive list of mollusks with unusual feeding habits is available in the appendix of Graham, a 1955 Molluscan Diets Journal of Molluscan Studies 31:3-4-144. 8 living classes, and 2 extinct ones. Although they are unlikely to form a clade, some older works combine the Caudophaveata and Selenogasters into one class, the Aplacophora. 2 of the commonly recognized classes are known only from fossils. Class major organisms described living species distribution. Caudophaveata worm-like organisms 120 seabed 200-3000 meters 660-9840. Rocky tidal zone and seabed. Monoplacophora, an ancient lineage of mollusks with cap-like shells. 31 seabed 1,800-7,000 meters 5,900-23,000. Scaphopoda tusk shells 500 marine 6-7,000 meters 20-22,966. See also, evolution of cephalopods. The use of love darts by the land snail Monocoides vicinus as a form of sexual selection. Fossil record. Good evidence exists for the appearance of gastropods, cephalopods and bivalves in the Cambrian period. 541. Spirally coiled shells appear in many gastropods. However, the Helchonellids, which first appear over 540 million years ago in early Cambrian rocks from Siberia and China, are thought to be early mollusks with rather snail-like shells. Shelled mollusks therefore predate the earliest trilobites. Although most Helchonellid fossils are only a few millimeters long, specimens a few centimeters long have also been found, most with more limpet-like shapes. The tiny specimens have been suggested to be juveniles and the larger ones adults. Some analyses of Helchonellids concluded these were the earliest gastropods. However, other scientists are not convinced. These early Cambrian fossils show clear signs of the torsion that identifies modern gastropods. Twists the internal organs so the anus lies above the head. Volborthella's classification is uncertain. The late Cambrian fossil Plectronoceras is now thought to be the earliest clearly cephalopod fossil, as its shell had septa and a siphuncle, a strand of tissue that Nautilus uses to remove water from compartments it has vacated as it grows, and which is also visible in fossil ammonite shells. However, Plectronoceras and other early cephalopods crept along the seafloor instead of swimming, as their shells contained a ballast of stony deposits on what is thought to be the underside, and had stripes and blotches on what is thought to be the upper surface. All cephalopods with external shells except the nautiloids became extinct by the end of the Cretaceous period 65 million years ago. However, the shell-less coleoidea squid, octopus, cuttlefish are abundant today. The early Cambrian fossils Fordia and Poheteia are regarded as bivalves. Modern-looking bivalves appeared in the Ordovician period, 488. Lophotrochozoa brachiopods. Bivalves. Monoplacophorans, limpet-like, living fossils. Gastropods. Snails, slugs, limpets, sea hares. Cephalopods. Nautiloids, ammonites, squid, etc. Scaphopods. Tusk shells. Aplacophorans. Spicule-covered, worm-like. Polyplacophorans. Chitons. Halwaxiids. Weewaxia. Halkaria. Orthrozanclus odontographus. A possible family tree of mollusks 2007 does not include annelid worms, as the analysis concentrated on fossilizable hard features the phylogeny evolutionary family tree of mollusks as a controversial subject, in addition to the debates about whether Kimberella and any of the halwaxiids were mollusks or closely related to mollusks. Debates arise about the relationships between the classes of living mollusks. In fact, some groups traditionally classified as mollusks may have to be redefined as distinct but related mollusks are generally regarded members of the Lophotrochozoa, a group defined by having trochophore larvae and, in the case of living Lophophorata, a feeding structure called a lophophore. The other members of the Lophotrochozoa are the annelid worms and seven marine phyla. The diagram on the right summarizes a phylogeny presented in 2007. Because the relationships between the members of the family tree are uncertain, it is difficult to identify the features inherited from the last common ancestor of all mollusks. For example, it is uncertain whether the ancestral mollusk was metameric, composed of repeating units. If it was, that would suggest an origin from an annelid like worm. Scientists disagree about this. Garibet and colleagues concluded, in 2006, the repetition of gills and of the foot's retractor muscles were later developments, while in 2007, Sigwart concluded the ancestral mollusk was metameric, and it had a foot used for creeping and a shell that was mineralized in one particular branch of the family tree. The shell of conchiferans is thought to have evolved from the spicules, small spines of a placophorans, but this is difficult to reconcile with the embryological origins of spicules. The molluscan shell appears to have originated from a mucus coating, which eventually stiffened into a cuticle. This would have been impermeable and thus forced the development of more sophisticated respiratory apparatus in the form of gills. Eventually, the cuticle would have become mineralized, using the same genetic machinery engrailed as most other bilaterian skeletons. The first mollusk shell almost certainly was reinforced with the mineral aragonite. The evolutionary relationships within the mollusks are also debated, and the diagrams below show two widely supported reconstructions: mollusks aculifera. Selenogasters, Caudophaveata, Polyplacophorans, Conchifera, Monoplacophorans, Bivalves, Scaphopods, Gastropods, Cephalopods. The aculifera hypothesis: mollusks Selenogasters, Caudophaveata, Testaria, Polyplacophorans, Monoplacophorans, Bivalves, Scaphopods, Gastropods, Cephalopods. The Testaria hypothesis: morphological analyses tend to recover a conchiferan clade that receives less support from molecular analyses, although these results also lead to unexpected paraphylies, for instance scattering the bivalves throughout all other mollusk groups. However, an analysis in 2009 using both morphological and molecular phylogenetics comparisons concluded the mollusks are not monophyletic. In particular, Scaphopoda and Bivalvia are both separate, monophyletic lineages unrelated to the remaining molluscan classes. The traditional phylum Mollusca is polyphyletic, and it can only be made monophyletic if scaphopods and bivalves are excluded. A 2010 analysis recovered the traditional conchiferan and aculiferan groups, and showed mollusks were monophyletic, demonstrating that available data for selenogasters was contaminated. Current molecular data are insufficient to constrain the molluscan phylogeny, and since the methods used to determine the confidence in clades are prone to overestimation, it is risky to place too much emphasis even on the areas of which different studies agree. Rather than eliminating unlikely relationships, the latest studies add new permutations of internal molluscan relationships, even bringing the conchiferan hypothesis into question. Human interaction. Main article: mollusks in culture for millennia. Mollusks have been a source of food for humans, as well as important luxury goods, notably pearls, mother of pearl, Tyrian purple dye, sea silk, and chemical compounds. Their shells have also been used as a form of currency in some pre-industrial societies. A number of species of mollusks can bite or sting humans, and some have become agricultural pests. Uses by humans. Further information: seashell and list of edible mollusks. Mollusks, especially bivalves such as clams and mussels, have been an important food source since at least the advent of anatomically modern humans, and this has often resulted in overfishing. Other commonly eaten mollusks include octopuses and squids, whelks, oysters, and scallops. In 2005, China accounted for 80% of the global mollusk catch, netting almost 11 million tons. 11 million long tons, 12 million short tons. Within Europe, France remained the industry leader. Some countries regulate importation and handling of mollusks and other seafood, mainly to minimize the poison risk from toxins that can sometimes accumulate in the Animals saltwater pearl oyster farm in Seram, Indonesia. Most mollusks with shells can produce pearls, but only the pearls of bivalves and some gastropods, whose shells are lined with nacre, are valuable. The best natural pearls are produced by marine pearl oysters, Pinctada margaritifera and Pinctada mertensi, which live in the tropical and subtropical waters of the Pacific Ocean. Natural pearls form when a small foreign object gets stuck between the mantle and shell. The two methods of culturing pearls: insert either seeds or beads into oysters. The seed method uses grains of ground shell from freshwater mussels, and overharvesting for this purpose has endangered several freshwater mussel species in the southeastern United States. The pearl industry is so important in some areas, significant sums of money are spent on monitoring the health of farmed mollusks. Byzantine Emperor Justinian I, clad in Tyrian purple and wearing numerous pearls. Other luxury and high-status products were made from mollusks. Tyrian purple, made from the ink glands of murex shells. Fine, rare, and valuable fabric produced from the long silky threads byssus secreted by several bivalve mollusks, particularly Pinna nobilis, to attach themselves to the seabed. Procopius, writing on the Persian Wars circa 550 CE, stated that the five hereditary satraps governors of Armenia who received their insignia from the Roman emperor were given chlamys or cloaks made from lana pinna. Apparently, only the ruling classes were allowed to wear these chlamys. Mollusk shells, including those of cowries, were used as a kind of money. Shell money in several pre-industrial societies. However, these currencies generally differed in important ways from the standardized government-backed and controlled money familiar to industrial societies. Some shell currencies were not used for commercial transactions, but mainly as social status displays at important occasions, such as weddings. When used for commercial transactions, they functioned as commodity money, as a tradable commodity whose value differed from place to place, often as a result of difficulties in transport, and which was vulnerable to incurable inflation if more efficient transport or gold rush behavior appeared. Bioindicators. Bivalve mollusks are used as bioindicators to monitor the health of aquatic environments in both fresh water and the marine environments. Their population status or structure, physiology, behavior, or the level of contamination with elements or compounds can indicate the state of contamination status of the ecosystem. They are particularly useful since they are sessile, so that they are representative of the environment where they are sampled or placed. A typical project is the Mussel Watch program, but today they are used worldwide. Stings and bites. The blue-ringed octopus's rings are a warning signal. This octopus is alarmed, and its bite can kill. A risk of food poisoning from toxins that accumulate in mollusks occurs under certain conditions, and many countries have regulations that aim to minimize this risk. Blue-ringed octopus bites are often fatal, and the bite of other octopuses can cause unpleasant symptoms. Stings from a few species of large tropical cone shells can also kill. However, the sophisticated venoms of these cone snails have become important tools in neurological research and show promise as sources of new medications when handled alive. A few species of mollusks can sting or bite, and, with some species, this can present a serious risk to the human handling the animal. To put this into perspective, though, deaths from mollusk venoms are less than 10% of the number of deaths from jellyfish stings. All octopuses are venomous, but only a few species pose a significant threat to humans. Blue-ringed octopuses in the genus Hoplocleina, which live around Australia and New Guinea, bite humans only if severely provoked, but their venom kills 25% of human victims. Another tropical species, Octopus apollyon, causes severe inflammation that can last for over a month even if treated correctly, and the bite of Octopus rubescens can cause necrosis that lasts longer than 1 month if untreated, and headaches and weakness persisting for up to a week even if treated. Live cone snails can be dangerous to shell collectors, but are useful to neurology researchers. All species of cone snails are venomous and can sting when handled. Although many species are too small to pose much of a risk to humans, these carnivorous gastropods feed on marine invertebrates and, in the case of larger species, on fish. Their venom is based on a huge array of toxins, some fast-acting and others slower but deadlier. They can afford to do this because their toxins require less time and energy to be produced compared with those of snakes or spiders. Many painful stings have been reported, and a few fatalities, although some of the reported fatalities may be exaggerations. Only a few larger species of cone snails which can capture and kill fish are likely to be seriously dangerous to humans. The effects of individual cone shell toxins on victims' nervous systems are so precise as to be useful tools for research in neurology, and the small size of their molecules makes it easy to synthesize them. The traditional belief that a giant clam can trap the leg of a person between its valves, thus causing drowning, is a myth. Parasites skin vesicles created by the penetration of Schistosoma source, CDC schistosomiasis, also known as bilharzia. Bilharziosis or snail fever is transmitted to humans via water snail hosts, and affects about 200. Well as to many islands in the Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean in the 1990s, this species reached the West Indies. Attempts to control it by introducing the predatory snail Euglandina rosea proved disastrous, as the predator ignored Achatina fulica and went on to extirpate several native snail species. Instead, despite its name, Molluscum contagiosum is a viral disease, and is unrelated to mollusks. Footnotes: carrot spelled mollusks in the U.S., see reasons given in Rosenberg's. For the spelling mollusk, see the reasons given by Brussels. Mollusca, shorter Oxford English Dictionary, Oxford University Press. EFGHIJKLMNOPQ Ruppert, pp. 284-291 ABCD Ruppert, pp. 291-292 AB Ruppert, pp. 292-298 ABC Ruppert, pp. 298-300 ABCD Ruppert, pp. 300-343 Ruppert, pp. 343-367 ABC Ruppert, pp. 367-403 AB Ruppert, pp. 403-407 ABCD Ponder, W.F., Lindberg, Dr., eds. 2008. Phylogeny and Evolution of the Mollusca. Berkeley, University of